Procreate Surge, and today I am going to be redrawing my very first attempt at photorealism. So throughout this video, there will be a bunch of tips on how to improve your own realism art. Yeah, let's get started. So for the sketching, it just really depends on you because everyone has a different way that they like to sketch. Some people really like to use the grid method, while others get super intricate with the measurements and everything. For me, I just like to block in the shapes and then I go in with the details because that's just a method that works for me. I also suggest that y'all add in the highlights and shadows beforehand, so when you're coloring, you can just focus on getting the colors right and not about where the shadows and highlights are. And also make sure to use an eraser and get the pencil lines light so that they don't see through when you're actually coloring. When I'm starting the coloring, I like to lay in the flat colors, and some of you may like to use bases. I know some popular ones are like using watercolors for bases or markers, and I do use markers later on in this piece when the problems start to arise, but for now, I'm just going to do some bases with the color pencils themselves. For the actual coloring, I think that's really calming and kind of mindless in a way because you can just color and you don't really have to think about like what you're coloring or where the light sources are or anything because you're using a reference, hopefully. Oh, and speaking of references, I had a couple of people asking me like where to find some good references. So I've been using Pinterest for the past 5-ish months, but I know that you can also use like Google and stuff. And I do that because a lot of artists that I follow also use Pinterest, and something that I do a lot is I go onto their accounts, find their boards, and see the pins that they save because it really helps me find more references that they use like that. And so yeah, building up a good collection of references like anatomy, practice, and proportions, and pose ideas, and hair, and all that stuff is really nice. Also, I do have a Pinterest account at Hershey Doodles if you want to go and follow me, I guess. I have a lot of people asking me how I have the motivation to finish my drawings. This one particularly took me like 8 hours, and so it's easy to see how someone can lose interest in a drawing. I'm the type of artist that loves to do long-term projects. Like, I can't come up with ideas every single day or anything like that. So doing longer drawing things like this is actually something that I enjoy. But here's something that also helps me keep interest, is to start out by drawing a part of the drawing that you actually are interested in or really like. I have a weird obsession with drawing shiny things, like I really like shading them and coloring them. So I started out by rendering, is that the word, the cherry, because it looked really fun to color. Basically, you just start out by coloring what you like in the drawing so you feel more motivated to finish. Thank you. Yes, the frosting. Let me just say this, that me and texture, we do not get along. I think the reason I love doing shiny things is because there usually isn't any like texture involved. It's just kind of really smooth. But the frosting has like a grainy texture, which I had no idea how to replicate. So I tried to do this one strip of frosting. As you can see, it doesn't look good at all. And so I did the next logical thing. I grabbed my markers and I started doing a base layer on top of the color pencil base layer. And yeah, that does not make any sense. I'm not even sure why I did it, because I don't think it helped the drawing at all. But after I did the base layer, I did my best to add the highlights and shadows. And another big issue that I had was I didn't have like a deep purple, so I had to blend a dark blue, a dark red, and a brown to get the color that I wanted. Anyways, I tried to keep myself from blending the color pencils too much on the frosting, because the color pencils already have this greeny texture, and because I used the marker base, I didn't have to blend the color pencils and to make it look good. So it was just kind of like layering the colors next to each other, but it wasn't actually blending them, if that makes any sense. And in the end, I'm fairly happy with how the frosting turned out. It had been 7 hours and I was feeling kind of tired and not very motivated to finish this drawing. I just had to do the wrapper, but I've been dreading it because I have no idea how I would color it. Again, it didn't have like a shiny look like the fudge sauce or the cherry, but it also didn't have any defined texture to it like the frosting. And so I went in with another base layer of markers because I didn't know what the heck to do, and I think that somewhat helped. I seriously have no idea. Lighting was also really dramatic in this area, and I used color pencils to mark out the different like colors of the wrapper because it was kind of multicolored. Some parts of the wrapper were like this really dark purple color and others were like really red. And so I used color pencils to mark out where that was, and then finally I went in and did like each individual kind of ruffle of the wrapper. I think there probably could have been like a better way to do this, because it was like really really time consuming for me to do this, but in the end I think that this came out good. It's definitely not my favorite part of the drawing, but I think that after I put in all this work, it was nice. I also didn't film like the second half of me doing this, because I think that watching me suffer this much is enough for the video. Adding the final touches was really fulfilling because it really brings the whole piece together. As you can see, I'm erasing some of the pencil marks because I just cannot color inside the lines. Like, you call yourself an artist, girl? Anyways, I realized that my desk was like a literal mess. So then I went ahead and I did like a quick cleanup, which is actually really satisfying on time lapse. So yeah. Here is the final comparison. This is the sketchbook that I drew my old cupcake in. You get to see some of my old cringy art. Yay, be thankful. You're welcome, I guess. And here's the cupcake itself. On to the final comparison though, the side by side. Woohoo! Drum roll please. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Here's the final comparison. There are so many differences, like the wrapper looks a lot better, the frosting, it just looks so good, and I'm really proud of myself. So thank you guys so much for watching till the end. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye!